the sound of pipes and drums. You either love it or hate it. But every year, hundreds of people in Northern Ireland don kilts and sporrans to take part in pipe band competitions. Why do they do it? There's not much financial reward for all the time and dedication it takes to come first in a competition. For those competing, winning is everything, and emotions often run high. This summer, our cameras followed three bands as they battled to win the All-Ireland and World Championship titles in their respective grades. Get ready to meet them and see tempers fray as they prepare to compete in the All-Ireland Championships.
It shouldn't be happening. And it's annoying me when I stand in that line listening to honk, honk, honk.
It's been f***ing lacking all night there. It's not really there.
And that note, dee-dum-da, that's a hell note. He's aren't howling it. Try it again.
Pipe band world is a very, very competitive world. And the bottom line is, it's about success. And it's about me being better than you. To play the bagpipes takes an amount of dedication. It's not everybody that make it, and it's only a certain individual that'll stick at it. You have to be very patient. You have to really want to do it. You have to have a lot of musical ability.
Noel's the pipe major, or leader, of Ballinderry Bridge, a grade 2 pipe band from County Tyrone.
Ballinderry Bridge pipe band, I would describe them best as they're a great bunch of fellas. They're country fellas with a country attitude. Rough and ready, but can play a bit.
Although it's his job to tutor and organise the band, competing in a pipe band means you need a team effort from everyone.
I'm very fortunate to have people in the band, for instance, like Conor McCallion. When he first came, he was as bad a learner as ever I came across. He could do nothing. He couldn't put his fingers on the chanter. He wasn't able to comprehend what I wanted him to try to do. And after about 2 months of that, I just couldn't get rid of him. I suggested that he took a good long break. I thought myself he wouldn't come back. But after about a week, the phone started to ring and he had to come around. And he had improved. And from that day to this, he has steadily improved. But I have to confess that I've done everything in my power to try to get rid of him.
Pipping for myself gives me a lot of buzz. Even at the band practice, when it's going well, there's excitement inside you. And then once you're finished playing, if you've a good tune, you're walking about with a smile on your face the rest of the day. Most of my friends would play football an awful lot, like, but I wouldn't play as much. They'd be out kicking a football and I'd be in playing the bagpipes.
He would put the pipe in first. The discos and the football become second and third. So the friends, I think, understand that no matter how they played, no many phone calls they make, or you'll come out. If there's a competition the next day, he won't, and that's it.
That's grand.
14-year-old Connor's not found it so comfortable playing the pipe since he broke his arm falling off his bike. Just before the competition season, it wasn't the best timing. Today, he's at the hospital for an x-ray and checkup, hoping to get a lighter cast fitted.
Fracture is in a good position,
yep.
And he would be happier to leave your plaster on for another 3 weeks.
Yep.
Okay.
I was hoping to get a lead plaster off, but a lead plaster on, sorry. But this is not going to save for to keep this and all. So, 3 weeks' time, all of us coming off, so that'll be enough.
Just outside Lisburn, it's another practice for the Field Marshal Montgomery Band, led by pipe major Richard Parks. They're grade 1 world champions, so officially, the best pipe band in the world. Mark's one of the pipers. He not only has to balance the band with his work, he's got a growing family too.
You want to show him how you can work on the monkey bars, Courtney?
Oh, I'm married 7 years to my wife, Lorna, and we have now 2 girls. The eldest is Courtney, who is 6, and Anna is 3 past in January. To balance pipe bands with my home life and my work life is can be quite difficult. Like any father knows, children want you to spend time with them. They don't see anything else, and you have to fit obviously practice in and then go to practices plus competitions. Lorna is expecting our third child on the 18th of August, 2 days after the World Championships in Glasgow.
He wouldn't miss the birth, he would miss the Worlds. He would have to, I think if he asked me, he would definitely answer it that way, you know.
If she goes early, in my mind would be a good thing, because it allows me to obviously get the most important thing out of the way, obviously her health and the baby's health, and it gives me a bit more free space in my mind to concentrate on the World Championships.
Hopefully it'll not collide on the 16th of August.
Guy, another of the band's pipers, rarely makes band practice, not due to his work, but because he lives hundreds of miles away in Coventry.
My job allows me to be very flexible with my hours of attendance, and it suits me for practice reasons as much as anything else to finish around about three, four in the afternoon so I can get home and get some decent practice done. I practice here in the kitchen. Main reason is that it's a slightly higher ceiling in here than it is in the bedroom. And also it's further away, there's an end terrace, it's furthest away from the neighbours next door, and there's a gap obviously there between the end of our house and the next door's house.
Guy plays for 30 minutes continuously every night.
It's very tiring, that is. Normally first thing after that is opening in the shower and try and clean myself off and cool myself down. Yeah, it's a long time to practice, but I feel it's important to do it non-stop because it keeps my stamina up and my ability up to be able to play for a long time. You can't really switch off from piping. The only way I switch off from piping is go to work, because there isn't a way from it. There's no way to do it. Good session down the pub sometimes, but that's usually with Ryan, and we just end up talking about bagpipes all night, so you don't switch off that much.
Near Kilray, Grade 3B band Quinn Memorial are practicing in a converted hen house. Piping's a family affair for pipe major Harry Broomfield, with not only his sister, but his wife Melita in the band as well.
Having Melita in the band as a piper, well, it has its moments. Sometimes when things isn't going well, maybe she gets the blame for things that maybe she shouldn't.
If there is something going wrong with the band, it's probably my fault, even though I haven't made the mistake, or it would be Gillian's fault, his sister. But we get used to this. He feels he can shout at us and we don't take it to heart.
So All-Ireland's coming up now in, what, about a fortnight's time. There'll be a lot of competitors up there from the south of Ireland. So I think we'll have to just go out there and really give it to them, because they're all expecting us to do well.
One of Quinn Memorial's drummers, Gary, has a unique talent. Profoundly deaf, he's had to learn how to drum in perfect time without being able to hear.
He enjoys learning to play the tenor drum. He also enjoys getting out with other friends in the band. He's made a lot of friends in that band now.
Gary learns and practices with the help of a video of his bandmates.
My husband and I are both very, very happy now that he's got into the band. We're very proud of him, so we are too.
The bands are competing in the Mid-Ulster Championships. It's not really a big competition, but nerves are present as the All-Irelands are approaching.
Doesn't matter what competition it is, there's still an amount of nerves there. I think you need nerves really to keep the adrenaline going and keep the concentration there really, you know. So.
Let's try and focus on the performance today and put everything else out of our head and let's do the business.
The pipe major for a band can be the most rewarding job in the world, or it can be the most frustrating, annoying, pile of hassle that you ever come across.
Have to keep the pressure on them. If you don't keep humming, the sticks will lie down on you. Here's their wild men. No, they're coming dilly-dallying, they're still in the car park.
Gary, Melita and Harry's band, Quinn Memorial, are in one of the lower grades, so they're one of the first to perform for the judges.
Just think. They're the main ones.
Job done. Gary relaxes. Next up, our Ballanderry Bridge. Gives Noel some feedback.
The band is brilliant, right? The sound is excellent.
I thought a wee bit in the chances here and there just would control them.
A wee bit in terms of continuity, the titles they're playing. But it's clear the sound is brilliant. That's the best I've heard the band in a long time.
That's good. I still think there's more in it, really. I know we can play that wee bit better. But...
Finally, Field Marshal Montgomery take the stage. The crowd love it, but would it be good enough to come first at the All-Irelands in Newcastle?
We could have played a lot better, to be honest, but we got a bit of a talking to there, so everybody has a bit of extra work to do this week to try and get it up to where it needs to be.
Maybe some people were just a little bit complacent today and maybe didn't put the work in that they needed to prior to the occasion, and I wouldn't be happy today if that today was Newcastle. I would hope that we would be better there as well.
Soon it's crunch time, prize giving, and the bands find out if they've got the coveted first place in their grade. First to find out will be Harry's band, Quinn Memorial.
Grade 3B, first place for the President, SA Glasgow Trophy, Quinn Memorial.
Great result, the one basically everything apart from them and these.
Yo!
There you go.
Who's forgetting the beers there?
Yeah,
who's getting the beers
there?
Next, it's Connor and Noel's turn to find out their position.
Grade 2, third place for Piping Preference for the Tom Hutchison Memorial Cup, Ballanderry Bridge, programme number 6.
A lot of people thought that we should have been first in piping, and maybe if we had been first in piping, we could have been maybe a second even would have been a better result, but third wasn't the best result for us. But.
Probably enough, at this point it's the same thing. Right.
Lastly, it's the grade 1 results.
First place for the Kingstown Burgess Trophy, Bill Morrison Montgomery, programme number 4.
In the end, Richard had nothing to worry about.
Enjoy your mom. But the band have won 4 awards today. First overall, first in piping, first in drumming, and the best bass section. So it's a good day, and we know we can play better, so that's the important thing.
We're ready, lads. We're ready to go here. Let's get the guys in. Come on.
With just 1 week before the All-Irelands, all 3 bands are hard at work.
Shh, 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 shh. Please, boys. You had a good attack here, boys. It's been lacking all night there. It's not really there. Don't overblow that. And any boys in the corner, throw them out there, Jeff. There's no beer on Friday night and a good night's sleep, and we're there and plenty of time. Boys, I'm serious here, boys, we need to give it a good price on Saturday.
Things went pretty good this evening. It was fairly laid back. A few wee bits and pieces to tidy up. Nothing major.
It wasn't bad. It's pretty good overall. Let's not underestimate any of the opposition. That's us done tonight. We're getting together about 1:30 tomorrow just to make sure everybody's there in one piece and stuff. Take it easy tonight.
The day of the All-Irelands has finally arrived. Bands from all over Northern Ireland and the Republic have travelled to Newcastle in County Down to battle it out. Whatever their grade, their goal is to pick up an All-Ireland title. The pressure's on for our 3 pipe majors, and practice continues right up to the last minute.
And that note, dee dum da, that's a hell note. He's earned a howl.
We're getting closer to the line. We'll be on another 5 minutes, so tension's getting there. We're all getting a wee bit nervous.
Lorna and the girls have come down with Mark to give Field Marshal Montgomery their support.
People always think that the waiting about is the worst time, and it probably is. Everybody's just sort of itching to get the pipes going and see how it really sounds and see what works ahead of us.
But although it's 1:30, there's no sign of Richard's drummers.
Okay, socialising and everything is now over, okay? We'll draw a line under it. No more socialising. Let's do the job now, lads. Let's start focusing on what we have to do today, because we've not been up to now. We've been all over the place. We don't know where we're meeting. Drummers are over there. We're here. It's time to start getting things together, okay? So let's do it.
Guys made the trip from Coventry.
Well, confident today. We're sounding reasonably good at the moment. So there's no reason why we can't go away for the prize.
Meanwhile, Ballanderry's Connor has had a bit of timely luck.
I got the cast off Morham on Wednesday. It was good relief getting it off. I'm able to play fine with how it's on. And it was a bit funny at the beginning now, to be honest with you, but it's 100% now and I'm happy with it.
Right, lads, boys, forget about the judges and forget about all earning, forget about winning, boys. Please forget the things, because at the end of the day, all you have to do, boys, is play as well as you can. You know, that's all we can do. If somebody has a bad day or we have a bad day, it's not the end of the world. All right? Life goes on. Just, we're going to hear it here and try to have as good a tune as we can and make it hard for them. But okay.
Right, relax now. Good, solid E. No overblowing.
First up to perform on the day is Harry's band, Quinn Memorial.
Thank you.
lot of nerves in the band. You would have heard them. You'd have heard it coming through in the plane. There's an odd wee slip or two. And you never know. All depends how the rest of them play. We might be lucky enough.
Pressure's off now. I can try and forget about the run and just enjoy the rest of the day and start getting worried again when it comes near the results.
Next, it's Ballinderry Bridge's turn.
The next competitor in grade two is Ballinderry Bridge. Pipe major Noel Mullen, and they wear the black steered tartan.
I enjoyed that, I really enjoyed it. It's very good. I'm happy. I don't care about the results. Whatever the judge decides to do, if some bands play better, that's okay. If they haven't and he doesn't think they did, or he thinks they did, well, that's his decision. I'm happy with what we've done. It's been worthwhile, all the work's paid off, and I'm happy we've got things right when it counted. Delighted.
We had a good tune today. It was good performance. Went in, played well, sound retained the whole way. It was a good job.
And would you please welcome our first band today in grade one? Put your hands together, please, for the Field Marshal Montgomery.
Finally, Richard's band performed.
Good. My job's only half done though, still got a long to do.
Because they're in grade one, Field Marshal have to perform twice for the judges, and the second performance doesn't go as well. There's a bit of a hiccup just as the band start to play.
A very important part of the performance is the introduction and all striking in the pipes together. So it felt to me like some people on the line were a wee bit nervous with the start and maybe they could have concealed that a little bit better. We're opening the door, lads, and we don't need to do it. And whoever did it knows it, and we need to sort that out. I mean, we don't need to have that, you know? It's not going to do on the day of the words to have something like that. And I know that there's people standing that line nervous about their attack because they're striking the bag and making noises when we're standing the line. And it shouldn't be happening. And it's annoying me when I'm standing in that line listening to honk, honk, honk.
I think we've got a reasonable chance of coming in first. We have left the door open, you know, just at this level, it only takes a slight amount to just give that opportunity to another band who play their hearts out week in, week out. So, but yeah, I still think we've got a good chance.
It's the end of the day. All the bands have marched past the chieftain and await their fate. Will they get first place in their grade? Quinn Memorial find out first.
First place, the Burrell Memorial Cup, Quinn Memorial.
They've done it.
Yes, Bobby!
Best core drums in grade 3B, the J. Dollar Memorial Cup.
Brilliant.
I'm shaking. I'm so happy, I'm shaking. I can't believe it.
Ballanderry Bridge are about to find out if they're Grade 2 champions.
Second place, the Puppy Teaming Cup, Ballanderry Bridge, number 6 on the programme.
It's second place, not what Noah wanted, but the others celebrate.
Amazed.
Well, I but came close to it.
We win All Ireland. Next year we win it.
Lastly, it's the Grade 1 results.
All Ireland champion for 2003 on MSR preference for the Tom Gannis Memorial Cup, Field Marshal Montgomery.
It wasn't the usual clean sweep for Field Marshal, though.
Coming second in the medley, I suppose, is a bit of disappointment. But overall, we, as I say, we won the competition, so we're happy to get that.
A little bit disappointing we only came second in the medley selection, but we did open the door for Sir Lawrence at all. We had a decent start, so you know, we've got nobody to blame but ourselves, really.
Nothing negative is going to come out of this, lads, okay? It's only positive things we can take out of today. The band was good today, okay? We had a couple of things that were wrong, probably, at our end, and, you know, everybody knows what was wrong. We're going as well, if not better than we were this time last season. We just need to focus on that and keep it going forward. Don't worry about the result today. You know, these things happen.
We're All-Ireland champions for the 14th time in 15 years, so I think that's a pretty outstanding record and one that the band should be proud of.
Is there anything Richard's not happy about?
Yes, but I'll keep that to myself.
Glasgow's still a big opportunity for us to take it again. I still think it's the competition where it's still based on the day, on how you play.
Next time on Pipe Dreams, the bands travel to the World Championships in Glasgow. Richard's not pleased.
With the early challenge, why is that happening? Why didn't happen all week and then somebody does that walking up the line?
Noel has time for one last pep talk.
Here on then, boys, stand up and blow. And you get in here, boys, no matter what happens, everybody's on their own when you cross that line.
And Harry gets emotional.
No matter the result, we're a very good band.
And that's next Monday at the same time, 10:35, here on BBC One Northern Ireland. So, but anyway, the following episode of Pipe Dreams contains a bit of colourful language.
From Northern Ireland as they battle to win the All-Ireland and World Championship titles. Previously on Pipe Dreams, the bands competed in the All-Ireland Championships. The Quinn Memorial Band took first place in Grade 3B, Ballanderry Bridge came second in Grade 2, and Field Marshal Montgomery were All-Ireland champions in Grade 1. Coming up, the bands travel to Glasgow to compete for the ultimate piping prize. They're hoping to become world champions in their respective grades. It's 7 a.m. and there's only 2 days before the World Pipe Band Championships are held in Glasgow. The Field Marshal Montgomery Band will be defending the world title they won last year. So Pipe Major Richard Parks is feeling under a bit of pressure.
You're wrong to say that I'm not feeling nervous.
nervous. I'm always feeling nervous coming up to this time, but also I'm determined and positive about what lies ahead. I feel the band's in good shape and prepared well.
Not everyone from the band has been able to make it to Glasgow, though. Mark Smith, whose wife Lorna is due to give birth 2 days after the World Championships, hasn't made it. He's still at home. Noel Mullen and his Grade 2 band Ballanderry Bridge have also arrived in Glasgow. They're checking into the hotel, but it was an early start for them.
We had to get up at 5 o'clock this morning to get the boat. The boat was sailing at 7:30. We all met in Ballanderry at 6 o'clock to leave on the bus. The plan is just to relax today and tomorrow and have a band practice tomorrow night and then go away in the morning. I'm feeling anxious but happy that we're here and hopefully get a bit of rest for Saturday.
Back in Northern Ireland, Grade 3B band Quinn Memorial are having one last practice before they leave for Glasgow. Pipe Major Harry isn't taking anything for granted, despite the band winning their Grades All-Ireland title.
We suppose we're the best of a bad bunch, but we need to improve before the next one. Before the words, I would think now the tunes will be getting into them in fine detail and picking out wee bits that we're not just playing together. So we're going out there with a good chance of, you know, getting into the top three at least.
In Glasgow, Field Marshal Montgomery spent the afternoon practicing.
It's good. It's not perfect, but it's only Thursday. Now, it's tough work in the sun, okay? So see, tomorrow, lads, I don't need any hangovers. You can feel how hard it is, and we all can enjoy ourselves a wee bit tonight, but I tell you, it's hard work when you don't have one. So think about that tonight. It's sounding good there, but there's bits that need sorted out, like stupid mistakes and stupid things happening.
It's one of the hottest days of the year in Glasgow, which has caused problems for the band. Guy's happy with the way the practice went, though.
We've had a huge variance in temperature, which is not good for the pipes. But overall, the practice is a good start. Certainly it's a good start to be sounding like that on Thursday. So if we can tighten it up tomorrow, and then obviously on the Saturday as well, it'll be even better.
There we go.
Another band are making the trip to Scotland. Quinn Memorial's profoundly deaf drummer Gary is looking forward to Glasgow. On the boat, there's plenty of time to think about the upcoming championships. It's occupying the minds of Pipe Major Harry and his piping wife, Melita.
I hope we play all right tomorrow, but you never know, the nerves can affect you. Hopefully we'll play okay. See how things go when we start tuning up in the morning.
For the rest of the day, though, the band plan to relax. There won't be any more practicing before the big day tomorrow.
I have fallen for another, she can make her own way.
Another member of the Field Marshal Montgomery band is arriving. It's Mark. He wasn't sure if he was going to make it, as his wife Lorna was due to give birth only 2 days after the World Championships.
Lorna had her baby on Sunday morning at 7:06. She was admitted just about 6 o'clock, so it was a short birth to a little baby girl who we're going to name Molly Rebecca Smith. I'm glad I'm in Glasgow now for the big one, as we'll call it.
And keep that just thanks now.
The band's chances of winning the World Championships again are very good. The build-up has been good.
Noel's band, Ballanderry Bridge, are getting ready for their first practice in Glasgow. They're planning to practice in one of Glasgow's parks.
Boys, you just want to go up to Glasgow Green? Hey, boys, we'll go up to the Green.
Green, boys.
Hi.
After walking for 2 minutes, though, the band decide to practice somewhere more convenient.
Which one are you saying, I'm practicing in there?
Hey?
Walk over here, I'll do.
Hey? Hope this practice goes well.
Oh, sure, eh? All right. March.
While the band start to practice on one side of Glasgow, Field Marshal Montgomery's practice is already underway. Meanwhile, Quinn Memorial have decided to stop off on their way to Glasgow for a quick game of crazy golf.
I'm confident enough of it tomorrow, sure. If we can go out and do the stuff, I'll take a brave good band to beat us. I think, you know.
It's very dry. It's good, but it's, you know, it's going to be better than that tomorrow. We'll see how it goes tomorrow, okay? We check everything tonight, make sure everything's all right. And listen, guys, it's going to be an early start tomorrow, so let's all be sensible tonight. It was good at the end, and it was very good at the beginning. But it was very, very hot, and we're not used to that sort of temperature. And I think it takes the pipes a while to stabilise.
Like Richard, Noel's happy with his band at the practice.
Boys, I was happy how the band practice went tonight there. Is everybody else happy with boys?
Killed your best shot, boys.
But boys, going and taking part and standing up and just playing through it, boys, that's not going to do nothing. Boys, you've got to stand up from start to finish, and you've got to play, and you've got to blow. And you don't do anything, forget about it. Boys, no drink tonight, but I think that goes without saying. The only man I'm not fit to keep an eye on tonight is you, Mickey. The only man I'm not fit to keep an eye on. So I'll breathalyze you in the morning. Getting dark now. We'll have an early night tonight because we'll have a very early start in the morning.
Band practice just ended and we're about to get back to it. And hopefully we'll get home and get some rest. Martin needs all the rest of the game.
The practice tonight was not too bad. Tomorrow it's down till what happens on the day. Now you could have a fantastic run and you could have a bad run or a mediocre run. It's down to whatever happens on the day. So things should be okay.
Back at Field Marshal's hotel, the band have a quiet drink before heading to bed.
It's 6:30 in the morning now, and there's a lot of sleepy heads about. So we're just getting a breakfast, and there's about 5 or 10 minutes, and then we'll have to go up to get the bus and get up to the competition field.
No, it's not too bad. It's too early in the morning, Devin. Good
morning.
Noel and his band decide to walk to the championships rather than taking the bus.
We're playing first, as usual, but it's annoying, but you have to go on ahead and do it.
Quinn Memorial are also heading off to Glasgow Green, where the championships are to be held. Pipe Major Harry's feeling relaxed.
Thank you very much.
Not a nerve in my body. They seem to be all right now. No major hangovers. They seem to have all put a brave breakfast on them. That'll be all right. Ready to play at 10:30. Dressed and all.
Field Marshal Montgomery have also arrived at Glasgow Green. Richard's concerned that the heat may still be affecting the pipes.
Keep them in the shade. Get the pipes in the shade under the bus.
There's heats for some Grade 1 bands before they can play in the final, but Field Marshal have already qualified, being current world champions. The time they play at will be revealed later in a draw.
If you play at the start, it's usually a disadvantage, and if you play at the end, you've got absolutely everybody and his uncle watching you, and it does put a bit more pressure on you. So mid-pack's probably about the best to be in.
The 2003 World Pipe Band Championships are underway at Glasgow Green. There's over 7,000 musicians attending, with 230 bands coming together from as far afield as Canada, New Zealand, Japan and Oman. It's just prior to 9:00. One of the first bands to perform is Ballanderry Bridge, and Noel's feeling the pressure.
No, for sake, boys, I'm not going to say that again, but that's going to stop. I'm sick of listening to myself about it. If some man can't stop, don't start. I'll take that fucking chin. How many times have I told you, but you blew to the second last. You don't stop there at the second last bar. But it's open that far corner. Not too bad, you're over here. You can't fucking do that, boys. That's really disgusting to hear that. Don't do that again, boys. We'll take the fucking chin again. Some of the players are, I can see that there's a wee bit of tension in them. It doesn't help the sound any, you know, and not help the performance, so I'm trying to tell them not to panic, you know.
As the band are nearly ready to go on, there's time for just one last pep talk from Noah.
Here on then, boys, stand up and blow. And you get here, boys, no matter what happens, everybody's on their own when you cross that line, boys. Stand up and blow and try and howl it back. And don't die a death at the end. All right? Number one, mate. Okay.
Set number one. And that is, just to make sure you know, Hugh Kennedy.
The judges are ready, and it's time for Ballanderry Bridge to perform.
Okay, lads. Really enjoyed it. I thought we played well together. We didn't lose control of it. The tempos were pretty good. I was happy with the sound where I was at. I thought the ensemble was okay. We had a good start, and I'm just extremely relieved to have came so far and have given a good performance.
Well, another good tune. Good tune. Hopefully, we can do well in the results. All the hard work I've put in the past 7 years, it's worth it.
I don't mind if we don't get a prize, I don't care what the result is. We've pleased ourselves and we have to do that first of all.
Performance over. The band can spend the rest of the day before prize giving relaxing. Across the road, Richard's phone rings. Field Marshal Montgomery are about to find out what time they have to perform.
Yep, this is the draw now. That's us.
Yes. Nine, good.
Good, 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 good.
Number nine.
That'll do.
Quarter to two.
Man of two.
The band are due to play at 1:45. That gives them 2 hours to fine-tune their performance. On the other side of the green, it's last-minute practice for Quinn Memorial. They're next.
Somebody rushing over that there. Want that open? Da-da-dum, da-da-dum. Same again. I've heard the worst. Not sounding too bad at all.
It's time for them to play. Thank you.
the World Championship, you're always going to be that wee bit uptight compared to any other competition, you know. I'm happy enough.
We'll have to wait to see what the judges are. 29 more bands to go on now, so you never know.
When it comes to addressing his band, it's obvious Harry's happy with the performance.
No matter the result, we're a really good band.
Field Marshal fine-tune their performance. It's nearly time for them to face the judges.
Look, we need to get in there, lads. We've only got about 15 minutes to go. Get your jackets and hats. Did I start on it?
The band entered the Grade 1 arena.
We sounded before the performance was right before we went on, and we took that sound into the arena with us, so we're quite happy.
The performance went well, although there was a small problem earlier.
Just before we went on, we tried one final introduction before we went into the competition, and something went wrong. Piper had an early chanter, and it unsettled the band before we went in. I wasn't happy about that.
Early chanter? Why is that happening? I didn't have it all week, and then somebody does that walking up the line. That's the whole band on ease.
Who was right?
The very end.
Yeah.
Where was it?
My reaction was probably a reaction of through the tension that you feel when you play and you come off, and there's a release of tension, and my anger was probably that release. And you'll generally find that I do that every time we play. I really need to take myself off after we play to wind down a bit.
Because they're in Grade 1, Field Marshal Montgomery have to play twice for the judges. The second performance also goes well.
Well done, guys. Good run.
Yes!
We did what we do well, and I was happy, and that was our main objective today. Winning would be a bonus. It's certainly good enough to win, depending on how the judges view it. I mean, obviously it'll come down to their thoughts on our interpretation of the music and all of that, and how the other bands play as well. Now I'm gonna go and have a beer.
All 230 bands taking part in the World Championships have played. They walk past the chieftain and come together on Glasgow Green to find out whether or not they've won a title in their grade. All three of our bands nervously await the results. Quinn Memorial have come first in Grade 3B lots of times this year. Have they done it at the Worlds, though?
World champions in first place, winning the J.J. Cairns Trophy, Prince Charles, USA, number 50. Second place, winning an RSPBA ladies' gold, Breedy, number 27. Third place, winning the Graham Johnson Memorial Cup, Black Raven, Ireland, number 26. In fourth place, an ensemble preference, winning an A&M Pipe Band Sock Shield, Quinn Memorial.
Yeah! Well done, buddy. Good mark.
Yeah! Yeah, hands up.
There you go. It's not every day you're third in the world, is it?
We're fourth.
I am very happy for coming fourth in the World Championship. If I had a thought for 1 minute, standing here last year and we were third in grade 4A, and that we were going to be fourth in grade 3B the following year, I would have ate every woman in this park.
Harry's happy with fourth place. Now it's Noel and Connor's turn to find out Ballanderry's position. Their ambition is to finish in the top six.
Grade 2 World Champions 2003 in first place on ensemble preference, Clan Gregor Society, number 21. In fifth place, winning the Sandy Hill Services Cup, Ballanderry.
It's the result the band wanted. They finished in the top six.
I think this is just money. Thanks very much. No, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't too bad.
Band doing great today. The best hope we had all weekend was to get a prize, and fifth was a bonus to us. It was a privilege to get a prize.
It really hasn't sunk in yet with me because, as I say, I have myself that much talked into being ready for the boost to rest them up whenever we had a bad result. That it hasn't sunk in with me. It'll not sink in until tomorrow morning, probably when I'm on the boat or go home on Monday, and I'll probably appreciate it more. But it's great, great.
That great, just a big uproar, and as you can hear now, your horse is at Anaheim, but all great, good feeling inside.
Finally, Field Marshal Montgomery are about to discover if they're Grade 1 World Champions for the second year running.
...2003 Grade 1 World Champions. In first place, winning the RSPBA Jubilee Trophy and banner, House of Edgar Shots and Bankhead, number 12.
They're not first.
Grade 1, second place on MSR preference, winning the Windsor Trophy, Field Marshal Montgomery, number 9.
They're second.
Third place, winning Ian Campbell's Shield, Simon Fraser University, number 7.
There's no question that we were disappointed with the runner-up spot. The band played very well and we were happy with the performance. But the standard of all the top bands is so close to perfection that coming second is still an achievement to be proud of.
For another year, the World Championships are over, and the bands march out of the green. It's been a summer of hard work and dedication, which will be repeated again next year as the bands chase their pipe dreams.
Ghost, but at the most it's been a rude awakening.
the band this year was brilliant. We ended up champion of champions. Next year, the band's aim is to try to do better than this year. We'd love to win an All-Ireland.
Our aims for next year will be to try and win the World Championship.
Meet Lawrence.